السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us. And indeed, we have entered the month, the best month in the Islamic calendar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who can achieve the maximum spiritual benefit from this particular month. Let us not be from amongst those who are cursed, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us through the lips of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَيْلٌ لِّمَنْ أَدْرَكَ رَمَضَانَ فَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ. Destruction be upon the one who has witnessed the month of Ramadan and has not been forgiven. So we ask Allah not to make us from that one, but rather to make us from the one who can be forgiven every single day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us spiritual elevation. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters and dearest listeners, I'm sure you are waiting attentively to listen to what the subject of discussion shall be tonight. Last night was quite a lengthy subject. The reason why we had expanded it is because it is the most important topic discussed in the Quran, the topic of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tonight we'd like to discuss the topic of justice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us justice in our lives. Some of us are oppressed by others. We seek justice. Sometimes we will not achieve that justice in the dunya, but we will achieve it in the akhirah. And some of us, sadly, are oppressors who oppress others. We should learn a lesson or two from tonight's verses. Remember one thing, the verses of the Quran are so powerful, they have covered this entire topic of justice from every angle you can think of. So tonight, as we are looking through the various angles from which the topic of justice has been dealt with by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, we should take heed and ponder and draw lesson. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us every single lesson. Firstly, when it comes to our dealings, our business dealings, our borrowings, lending and borrowing and so on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, write it down. Don't just have a partnership without writing down. What is this partnership? How much is it? What percentage is it? Who holds what percentage and so on? How much do you owe this man and what does he owe you? This one borrowed from you and that one lent and so on. You need to write it down. This is in a verse in Surah Al-Baqarah known as Ayatul Mudayanah. The verse wherein this borrowing and lending is to be recorded and written. That is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this particular verse, He says, فَلْيُمْلِلْ وَلِيُّهُ بِالْعَدْلِ, speaking about one who is unable to write, either due to young age or either due to the inability to write. Allah says, the guardian or someone who is there on behalf of that person should write with justice. They should write with justice. So we need to be just when we are writing down our business transactions and deals. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us every form of benefit. Then we should understand that the issue of bearing witness is very closely connected to justice, because justice is served when someone can stand up and bear witness, correct witness. We ask Allah to protect us. One of the major sins is when a person bears false witness. They know what happened and they say something else. There are some people in many countries of the globe, very sadly, who stand outside the courts. They mill around and they look at the people who are looking worried there by the courts. I hope this is not happening in this country. And they say, look, I can bear witness. How much are you ready to pay me? Explain to me what happened. And I seen it. May Allah protect us. Believe me, if that is the case, we will lose. We will lose in the dunya. We will lose in the akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you bear witness, you should bear witness with justice, bearing in mind the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, all our business transactions, Allah says, deal with justice. When you are giving, give justly. When you are receiving, receive accordingly. And this is mentioned even in Surah Al-An'am, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْفُوا الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانَ بِالْقِسْطَ. You should fulfill the weights. When you are giving and receiving, fulfill it properly. And when you are weighing, say for example, the tomatoes, Sometimes some people have a weight such that it's already so heavy that the tomatoes they give are less. And when they are receiving, they receive a bit more. So you are stealing one tomato that way and one tomato this way. Two tomatoes per kilo. May Allah protect us. Those tomatoes will come on the day of Qiyamah to bear witness against us. Do we want that? No, we don't. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant every single one of us protection. Then in Surah Hud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of Shu'aib alayhi salatu wa salam. And this verse appears in many surahs with different wording, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Shu'aib alayhi salam told his people, as Allah mentions, وَيَا قَوْمِ أَوْفُوا الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تَبْخَسُوا النَّاسَ أَشْيَاءَهُمْ. O my people, when you weigh, weigh properly for the people with justice, and don't cheat the people out of their belongings and provisions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those whom when we do deals, we do them justly. Nowadays, the example of weighing tomatoes and weighing some carrots and so on might not apply to every single one of us in our businesses. But don't cheat in your business. Don't deceive in your business. The hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِن صَدَقَ وَبَيَّنَا بُورِكَ لَهُمَا فِي بَيْعِهِمَا. When a person is dealing and he is honest in his deal, he comes and says, look, I want to sell this car, but let me be honest with you, the CV joints are about to be, or they will be needing replacement very soon. And he is not cheating. He tells you, look, this was an accident damaged vehicle. That is now called justice in buying and selling. You are being open and honest and truthful. Allah says he will grant you barakah in your deals. And remember, barakah does not necessarily mean the amount, but it is how that amount shall be used and what will be achieved by that particular amount. So when it comes to business, we are reminded in so many surahs, there is one entire surah known as Al-Mutaffifun, those who cheat in business. And Allah says, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah says destruction upon those who cheat in business. When they weigh for themselves, they weigh a little bit more. And when they weigh against themselves, they weigh a little bit less. Meaning the dealings, as we mentioned moments ago, Allah says, don't those people think that they are going to be resurrected upon a very huge day, a very important day? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us conscious of the answerability to Him at all times. Then in Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah says, وَالسَّمَاءَ رَفَعَهَا وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانَ أَلَّا تَطْغَوْا فِي الْمِيزَانِ وَأَقِيمُوا الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُوا الْمِيزَانِ. Notice the word mizan, meaning the scales, and the word qist, meaning justice. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us every form of justice, inshallah. So Allah says, Allah has raised the skies and He has set the scales. Everything is in balance. And Allah says, you should not decrease when it comes to the balance. And you should not exceed the limits when it comes to the balance, when it comes to justice, when it comes to the scales. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection. Even the oxygen we breathe, Allah has balanced it. If it was not O2, we would not be able to breathe it. Or if we breathed it, it would affect us adversely because it was not balanced. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala balances everything for us. Subhanallah. We ask Allah's guidance. Then the next point of justice. I told you there are different angles from which justice is looked at in the Quran. Firstly, we spoke about business and dealings and writing things down and so on. Whether it is your father or brother, or no matter who it is, you must write things down and you must get people to bear witness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the importance of that. Tomorrow if someone dies, we don't want a problem. So even if it is your own son, you are in business with him, write down, my son, you own 25% here, it's written, we have two witnesses signed and it's proper, it's stamped and certified. Don't wait for the day now one of you die and then there's a huge dispute after that to say, but he was my son. And then one son says that I was in the business with my father, how can the rest of them get the same share when they were not in the business? Well, if your father did not write anything, then he was the problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. The next angle is in marriage. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about justice, more so in polygamy. When a person has more than one wife, look at the words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses. Someone who wants to get another wife, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا فَوَاحِدَةً أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ
Allah says, if you fear injustice, if you feel you will not be able to be just, then stick to one, it is better for you. Subhanallah. Why? You don't want to be cursed every day. The first one is making a dua against you. The second one is making a dua against you. The third one is making a dua against you. And your life is full of chaos. You'd rather stick to one where there is a lot of barakah and happiness. That is if you are fearing injustice. Now there is another verse in Surah An-Nisa speaking about justice between women. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَن تَسْتَطِيعُوا أَن تَعْدِلُوا بَيْنَ النِّسَاءِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتُمْ فَلَا تَمِيلُوا كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ فَتَذَرُوهَا كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ
You will never ever be able to be absolutely just between the women. So moments ago Allah said, if you are fearing injustice, stick to one. Then moments later he says, you will never ever be able to be just. Some people think that this is a contradiction in the Quran. The reality is, it is not a contradiction. Let me tell you, there are three very important things. Your time, your money and your love. When it comes to your time and your money, you own it. When it comes to your love, she owns it. Allahu Akbar. Your time and your money, you make sure that you divide it equally. Your time and your wealth. In that, you will never ever be allowed to be unjust unless one of them waives the right. One says, you know what, you're supposed to come to me once every second night, but no problem, I waive my night, for example. That is what Sauda binti Zam'ah radiallahu anha did in favor of Aisha radiallahu anha. She told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, look, no problem. Now I'm old and I'd like this night of mine to go to Aisha. Subhanallah, we wish we had wives like those, mashallah. Then, well, to be honest with you, if we wanted wives like those, we'd have had to be men like those as well. Subhanallah. And I think that is where we all start finding ourselves wanting. May Allah protect us all. Then we have justice in love. If a woman would like a man, or if a wife would like the husband to love her, she needs to sacrifice for him. The more she sacrifices, she gets up, she cooks, she looks after the children, she is smart, she is smiling, she is cheerful at all times, saying good words, what will happen to him? Naturally, his heart will incline towards her if he is a normal human being. And if he is not a normal human being, what will happen? He will still, even though she's tried and struggled and strived, he will still incline elsewhere. May Allah protect us from shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once distributed his wealth and time, then he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Allahumma hadha qasami fima amlik, fala tu'akhidni fima la amlik. O Allah, I have distributed what I own, which is the wealth and the time. But do not hold it against me, what I don't own. He said clearly, I love Aisha more than the rest. He said it loud and clear. I can't help it. It's me. Allahu Akbar. He said, فَضْلُ عَائِشَةٍ كَفَضْلِ الثَّرِيدِ عَلَى سَائِرِ الطَّعَامِ He says, the virtue of Aisha is far higher than the rest of the women. It is like the virtue of the favorite dish. When all the food is present, you would first go for the favorite dish. Subhanallah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about it. But he said, you must be just. And this is why when the Quran speaks about justice in love, the Quran says you will never ever be able to be completely equal. But do not let one hang in such a way that neither is she married to you, nor can she get married to someone else. Because some people, when they have more than one wife, What they tend to do is, one is just there. They are there, not yet divorced, but they never go there. So she is neither able to say, I am somebody's wife, because the husband is never there, nor is she able to marry someone else because she is not yet divorced. So Allah says, don't leave a woman hanging. That is a very great sin. If you want, you can either hold her or you can either release her. And this is why in Surah At-Talaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, regarding justice as well,
فَإِذَا بَلَغْنَ أَجَلَهُنَّ فَأَمْسِكُوهُنَّ بِمَعْرُوفٍ أَوْ فَارِقُوهُنَّ بِمَعْرُوفٍ.
When the iddah period, when the waiting period is over, then you should either hold them. You should either have already decided to hold them with goodness or to leave them with goodness. But don't leave them in the center hanging neither this way nor that way. Then Allah says,
وَأَشْهِدُوا ذَوَيْ عَدْلٍ مِّنْكُمْ وَأَقِيمُوا الشَّهَادَةَ لِلَّهِ.
When you are divorcing, it is best that you have two solid good Muslim witnesses, and you should bear witness for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a divorce takes place even if there are no witnesses, it's valid. But Allah says it is recommended that you have two witnesses, because tomorrow there might be a dispute. The husband might deny ever giving a divorce and the woman is stuck. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all an understanding. Then when it comes to justice, Allah speaks about two people, meaning two witnesses, not only one all the time. Why two? Because sometimes if there's one person, there is a possibility that people might say this person might just either be lying or might not have the accurate story, the accurate picture. You know, when it came to the moon at the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, it is reported that they were all looking. There was a clear sky. And what happened is, one old man was the only one who says, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I can see the moon. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu was surprised. The old man can see the moon. Those who are young cannot see the moon. We can all not see the moon. So he told that man, Imsah aynayk, wipe your eyes. So the man wiped his eyes. He says, Hal tarahu al-an? Do you see the hilal, the crescent now? He looked, he said, well, it was there just now. I was looking at it just now, moments ago. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu says,
La'alla sha'raka min hajibika taqawwasa alayka fara'aytahu hilala.
There is a chance that there was a hair from your eyebrow that was gray, that was coming down in front of your pupil. So you looked at it as a moon, but it wasn't a moon. Subhanallah. I hope we are not from amongst those who have large eyebrows. Then the Eid will be very early every single time. The reality is, we need to be just. And this is why it is best to have more than one witness, so that inshallah we will not be accused of favoritism. We will not be accused of anything bad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to stand firm for justice. And Allah says in Surah Al-An'am,
اثْنَانِ ذَوَا عَدْلٍ مِّنْكُمْ.
Allah speaks of two people who are just. Which means justice should be something that we are known by. People should look at us and say, that man is just, he is fair. How many of us are like that? Let's be honest. Even in our own homes, our spouses at times cannot bear witness that we are fair. Our own children cannot bear witness that we are fair sometimes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. This verse in Surah Al-An'am is connected to the bequest. When a person is dying and they happen to be on journey, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, get two witnesses if you would like to bequeath, and let them know exactly what is happening. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us conscious of our wills, whether or not we have actually written them, and whether or not they are Sharia compliant. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us every form of understanding. Then there is another very interesting angle from which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes a look at adl and justice. He connects justice with goodness. And there are two points we need to remember. What is the connection between justice and goodness? Two issues. The first is, to serve justice itself is already goodness. When someone owes you 50 rands, or let me word it another way, when you owe someone 50 rands, when another man comes in and justly makes sure that that particular 50 rand is now paid up, that is goodness. It is goodness for the one it is given to. It is goodness for the one whom the due belongs to. So that is the connection, or the first connection, between justice and goodness. is that justice itself is goodness, subhanallah. But in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and I'm sure we know this verse off by heart,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي.
No, you are wrong. It does not depict the end of my talk here. Subhanallah. Many people would probably think it's the end of the talk, because in Jumu'ah, when we hear this verse, everybody's happy. Now you see the smiles. Yes, now this imam here is finishing now. Alhamdulillah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection and understanding. Allah says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands and instructs justice and goodness. So he mentioned justice before goodness, and this brings us to the second point of the connection between the two. We cannot forego justice with the excuse of goodness. Someone owes you 50 rands. When someone else comes and says, brother, just forgive him. Your goodness. Allah says, Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan. You should tell them Allah says, adl before ihsan. Get me my 50 rands. Alhamdulillah. Allah says, justice before goodness. I'll be very good, but after I get my 50 rands. Notice how I'm making it only 50 rands. We don't want to get into a big debate in the masjid. The reality is, when we have been oppressed more than once, and we do not stand up firm for justice, sometimes we could be guilty of promoting vice and evil. A man wrongs you, you forgive him. That was goodness. He wrongs you again, you forgive him. He oppresses you again, you don't do anything about it, you forgive him. At times you might just become guilty of promoting that vice by making him get away with it. So that is why it is important you stand up for justice as well. That is why I said sometimes goodness dictates that you must be just, you must stand for that justice, don't give up your right sometimes. But you need to gauge that, obviously, and you need to weigh the situation. And this is why when we are speaking to others, don't always ask them to forgive and forget. No, not always. Sometimes an individual has the right to say, no, I would like justice, I want retribution, I want to seek revenge, retaliation. But may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness as well. Allah says,
وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ.
Do you want to know the best of affairs? Those who are patient and oft forgiving. Still, you know it's your right, but just forgive if you can. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you as well. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in Surah An-Nisa as well as in Surah Al-Ma'idah. A beautiful command which sounds quite similar, but the ending of it is different. Allah says,
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kunu qawwamina bil qisti shuhada'a lillah.
O you who believe, stand up firm for justice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This verse is repeated twice, once in Surah An-Nisa and once in Surah Al-Ma'idah. But in Surah An-Nisa, Allah says, stand firm for justice, every single one of you, even if it is against yourselves, or your parents, or your relatives, your friends. Don't ever forgo justice just because it is your father, or just because it is your brother, just because it is your son. No, justice comes before anything else. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he was judging between Ali ibn Abi Talib and a Jewish man, radiallahu anhu, Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, and a Jewish man, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ruled in favor of the Jewish man because of the evidence in front of him, subhanallah. That resulted, according to one of the narrations, in the acceptance of Islam of this Jewish man. Amazing, subhanallah. Look at how justice actually promotes goodness as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the justice, even if it happens to be against ourselves. That is actually a peak. When a man can stand up and say, look, I'm wrong. I really am wrong. I'm sorry. Subhanallah. That is now the peak of manhood. Because part and parcel of being a man is not only to get up and fight, but to admit when you are wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that quality. Then in Surah Al-Ma'idah, the end of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
كونوا قوامين لله شهداء بالقسط.
Stand up firm for the sake of Allah in justice. That means engage in justice, promote justice, stand up firmly for justice for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ.
Powerful verse of the Quran. Justice with your enemy. Allah says, the fact that you hate someone with a passion should not let you become unjust with him. Still you must be just. So you have an enemy of yours, but where they are right, they are right. Credit is due. Allahu Akbar. Where the enemy of yours is correct, he is still correct. And if your best friend is wrong, he is wrong. Look at the topic and look at how Allah is now drawing our attention to justice with the enemy. In fact, in another verse in Surah Al-Mumtahina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the same point. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not stop you from being good and from being just. Not only justice, but being good and kind to non-Muslims who have not directly fought you. They are not your warring enemies. Amazing. They have not fought you, nor have they driven you out of your homes and your properties. Allah says, Allah has not stopped you from being good to them and from being just to them. This verse means that we have to be just even to the non-Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to understand the depth of this religion. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the previous prophets and how they were also commanded and instructed to be just in a very, very stern manner. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Sad, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses Dawood alayhi salam, David, may peace be upon him, because there were two types of prophets. Those prophets who had authority on land as well. Dawood alayhi salam was a king, and so was Sulaiman alayhi salam. And some of the prophets, they were not kings, but they were prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Muslimin fell under them, and at times some areas fell under them, but they were not kings, some of them. Whereas there were others who were rulers and leaders. So Allah says to Dawood alayhi salam,
Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard.
O Dawood alayhi salam, we have made you a khalifa. We have made you a leader, a viceroy on this earth. We have made you a leader on the earth.
Fahkum bayna an-nasi bil haqq.
So when you judge between the people, judge with justice. And amazingly, some of the judgments of Dawood alayhi salam and his son Sulaiman alayhi salam are mentioned in the Quran. Some of the examples. We are not going to go through those examples tonight, but they are very interesting examples. Allah says,
وَلَا تَتَّبِعِ الْهَوَى فَيُضِلَّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَضِلُّونَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ بِمَا نَسُوا يَوْمَ الْحِسَابِ.
Allah says to Dawood alayhi salam, judge between the people with that which is correct. Be just when you are judging between people. And do not follow your desires, your whims, your fancies. You should judge with knowledge. And this brings us to another point. If you don't have knowledge, you cannot judge. It is haram for me or you to judge between two people without listening to the other side of the story. One person comes to you and says, you know, that man, really, he let me down and he stole my money and he pinched and he did this and he is a rotter and what have you. All sorts of words we use nowadays. And what happens is, we haven't yet heard the other side of the story and we go around saying the same thing. Yes, I know, we know, he's terrible and this is what he did. He cheated us of our money as well and he did this and he did that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. It is prohibited to make a judgmental statement without listening fairly to both sides of the story, complete equality when it comes to justice. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you are not going to guide according to knowledge, and if you are going to guide according to your whims and fancies, then you will be astray, and you will lead astray. And those who lead astray, for them is a severe punishment, because they forgot Yawmul Hisab, meaning the day of accounting. That is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to judge. So amazing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the importance of justice through mentioning what he told Dawood alayhi salam. Isn't it a stern message? When Allah is telling Dawood alayhi salam, be careful, if you are not just, it's going to lead you to the fire of Jahannam. May Allah protect us. That was a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was instructed as well. قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطُ. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling him, say, Allah has instructed justice. Allahu Akbar. The instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to say, وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ اللَّهُ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. Beautiful verses of the Quran. I have been commanded and instructed to judge between you with justice. أُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. I have been commanded and instructed to judge between you with absolute justice. For me is my deeds, for you are your deeds. Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all forms of goodness. Then, subhanallah, there is another angle of justice mentioned in the Quran. Who is it that can judge? When you've got a problem, you need to know, who can I go to? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about that as well in the Quran. Look at all the various angles this topic is being discussed from. If you want to know who to go to, or if you want to know who can be just, they are those with sound knowledge, as well as knowledge of the religion, and those who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's listen to the verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Anfal,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا.
O you who believe, it is only if you are conscious of your Creator correctly that you will be granted the ability to distinguish between right and wrong, between light and darkness, between the right and the left. Allahu Akbar. So it is only when you are conscious of your Creator that you will be able to judge, you will be able to distinguish. Those who are not conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will take the side of their friends. They will take the side without even thinking of those who are closer to them, of the wealthy, of the influential, because they are worried of the repercussions. But a person who has the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within him or her will definitely utter the truth, even if they have to reprimand those who are influential. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to judge and to make decisions as to whom we should go to judge between us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the verses that we read this evening, in Surah Al-Baqarah, towards the end, Allah says,
وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ.
Be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will teach you. He will show you the way. He will show you the difference between right and wrong. He will help you to distinguish. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, knowledge comes with the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, in Surah Ala Imran, also a verse that we read this evening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطُ.
Allah bears witness that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah. And who else bears witness? The angels bear witness. And who else bears witness? Those who have knowledge bear witness with justice. Now that justice is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He stands firm for justice. as well as the angels. The angels are very just. Why? They do not transgress the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As well as those who have knowledge, they are just. They are meant to be just. And they are the ones who can be just. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those. Then when someone is just, there are always problems that will come in their direction, because not everyone likes those who are just. Correct? When you are a witness, you are standing up for justice, a state witness or a prime witness, your life is at stake sometimes. Allah makes mention of this in the Quran as well. That there are some people who go out to harass those who are just. When you are dedicated and right and upright, and when you say, look, this is wrong and this is right, this is the line, we are drawing it here, there will be people who hate you and who dislike you. We ask Allah's protection. Allah says in verses that we shall be reading tomorrow in Surah Ala Imran,
وَيَقْتُلُونَ الَّذِينَ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْقِسْطِ مِنَ النَّاسِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making mention of certain categories of people who go out to fight those who are standing upon justice. So anyone standing upon justice should be ready. There will be people who will come and make their life difficult. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns those people and says, give them tidings, give them news of a severe punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the choice that we all have. There are certain times when we have a choice and certain times we do not have a choice. Whether or not to judge between people. Allahu Akbar. So sometimes when two people come to you, you have a choice. If you want, you can be the judge. They want you to be the judge, you can choose to be the judge. If you choose to be the judge, make sure that you judge according to the proper knowledge that you have, listening to both sides of the story, trying to find out what is the truth, and bearing in mind that justice is what is required of a Muslim. And if you fear that that will not be possible, it is best for you to abstain. You can turn away and decline. Sometimes there is a judge who might have a link with one of the two people, so he declines the case. Why? Because he knows I've got a link with this individual, there is some form of a discrepancy that might arise. When I judge and I give my ruling, there might be a problem. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
فَإِن جَاءُوكَ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ أَوْ أَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ وَإِن تُعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ فَلَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ شَيْئًا وَإِن حَكَمْتَ فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ.
When they come to you in order to judge, here Allah is speaking of the people of the book, the non-Muslims. When they come to you in order to judge between them in their disputes, you can choose to decline, no problem. And you can choose to judge. And if you judge, be very, very fair in your justice, because Allah loves those who are just. And that brings us to another angle from which justice is tackled in the Quran, where Allah declares His love for those who stand up for justice, even if the world hates them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who can stand firm for justice and who can recognize what is right at every single time. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and He makes mention. In fact, He praises those who are just, as I mentioned moments ago. And He says,
وَمِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا أُمَّةٌ يَهْدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ.
From amongst those whom we have created are people who are rightly guided and they stand firmly for justice. They guide others and they stand firmly for justice. So Allah knows them and He is praising them in these verses. In fact, even with the nation of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised from amongst them those who stand up for justice.
وَمِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى أُمَّةٌ يَهْدُونَ بِالْحَقِّ وَبِهِ يَعْدِلُونَ.
A similar verse, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of those who stand and establish justice, stand for and establish justice from amongst the people of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then there is a time when we have to stand up for justice. There is no taking, meaning no sitting on the fence. When is that? Allah says in Surah Al-Hujurat, when two Muslim groups are fighting each other, you cannot sit in the middle and say, I don't want to take sides. It is your religious duty to listen very carefully to both sides of the story from the source itself. We say from the horse's mouth, but I wouldn't like to call people horses. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, from the source, you must listen to the story from both sides. Then you need to take the side of the one who is right against the one who is wrong. You have to. You have no choice. So when there's a debate and a dispute, when the community is divided into two and they are both Muslim parties, you need to listen to both sides and take the side of the one who is right. If you don't do that, then very soon calamity will overtake you as well, because you are sitting back relaxed and you are not bothered about bringing together the Muslim Ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us justice. So Allah says,
فَقَاتِلُوا الَّتِي تَبْغِي حَتَّى تَفِيءَ إِلَىٰ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ فَإِنْ فَاءَتْ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا بِالْعَدْلِ وَأَقْسِطُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this point, that when two Muslim parties are battling each other, fighting each other, then you should try and make peace between them with justice. You don't make peace between them by siding with the ones who are noisemakers and tell them, you know what, don't worry, we are on your side, and then go to the quiet ones and say, look, you know what, you people are wrong. Just because you know they are quiet, and just because you know that those people are not noisemakers, they are not influential. No, you need to take the side of the one who is right. And Allah says, fight those who are oppressors if they continue in that oppression. Fight them until they come back. Once they come back, then you should make sure that the justice that you have arrived at was done so with proper equality, giving everyone a fair chance, being just. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to resolve our crises within the Muslim Ummah. Then, a very important point regarding justice. Allah says about the day of Qiyamah, that He is the one who is the most just, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at that angle. So if someone does not get justice in the dunya, they need not worry. They will get justice in the akhirah. They've just got to bear patience. And Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Anbiya,
وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا وَإِن كَانَ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ أَتَيْنَا بِهَا وَكَفَى بِنَا حَاسِبِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we have laid the scales of justice for the day of Qiyamah. For the day of Qiyamah, the scales of justice, when justice shall be served, have been laid. Subhanallah. So nobody shall be oppressed in any way. Allah says, even if it is a little mustard seed, Allah will bring it forth. Even if it is a little mustard seed, it is not going to hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With us, we oppress morning and evening. We backbite, we gossip, we slander, we make people's lives difficult. Huge issues we involve in. And we still think that Allah is not going to come up with that. When Allah says, even if there is one mustard seed, Allah will bring it forth. Subhanallah. And Allah says, we are sufficient as those who can take account. We are sufficient as those who can take account. Then a very interesting verse that we read this evening regarding bribery when it comes to justice. Amazing. I think we need it more in this part of the world, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning people not to buy over the rulers with their money. Not to buy over the rulers with their money. And this verse is in Surah Al-Baqarah.
وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَتُدْلُوا بِهَا إِلَى الْحُكَّامِ لِتَأْكُلُوا فَرِيقًا مِنْ أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ بِالْإِثْمِ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ.
Don't eat the wealth of one another unjustly. Do not eat the wealth of one another unjustly. And do not use that wealth to try and now get closer to the one who is judging, or to the rulers, or to those in authority. Some of the Mufassireen make mention of the issue of bribery. And they say there are some who bribe their way through the justice system. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not bribable. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about His messengers in Surah Al-Hadid, the surah where steel is mentioned. Iron and steel is mentioned in the surah Al-Hadid.
لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ.
Indeed, we have sent our messengers with clear manifest signs. Clear signs.
وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ.
And we have sent down with them two things. The books, number one. The messengers, what do they have? They have the books. And we have sent the scales with them. Whoever is going to follow the messengers, they will have the ability to distinguish between right and wrong. They will be just. They will not oppress. And Allah says, even the book itself has in it knowledge of how to be just. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us just. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطُ.
One of the reasons why we have revealed the book and the scale is so that the people can behave in a just manner and they can establish justice with truthfulness on this earth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us justice. At the end of this particular topic, I'd like to draw our attention to how many angles Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tackled the issue of justice from. We have only mentioned but a few. And inshallah, we will mention a different topic tomorrow. Until then, wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma.